Hey folks, Alamandic, Mandic really here for Studio Revamp number 3, the third video in the series where I'm turning this space into a ultimate makerspace 3D printing YouTube studio. I've got to get right to work in this video because I actually have a friend on his way over to help me move big heavy stuff. I can't move by myself and I didn't do the preparation work ahead of time that I needed to do, so let's get to it. We've got to move this couch, love seat, which means that that filament needs to move, and we've got to move this full Dell server rack with two servers inside of it down to the studio. And actually the couch is coming up here. You see, this used to be my office where I edited all these videos, did all my 3D design work, and we've decided that it makes more sense to turn this into a bit of a family game room and move myself into the studio. Also, the acoustics in here are awful, so let's go back to the studio. A little over a week ago, we decided to try out me moving my workstation. So my computer, one of my monitors, I'm hooked up to the TV, it's usually in the studio here, as a second monitor, and actually try it out for working in here, editing my videos, doing my design work, everything in the studio where I film. My fiance and I both own our own businesses, and we are not good at not working 24/7, so we're trying to create a healthier work-life balance. So the couch needs to go up into that space so we can have like a VR and gaming setup. Which this now means that all of the work I'm doing here in the studio to revamp things has to change even further so I can fit an office in here too. We just gotta start moving stuff. Let's go. And with that, the big stuff is moved. It's amazing how much easier things go when you let other people help you. There's one more big thing I need to move. I need to do some construction work on it. I need to insulate it with that rock wool back there. I need to paint it, and then I need to move it. And what I'm talking about is, okay, this is not the big thing that I meant, but this just arrived. This is the Elegoo Neptune 3 Max. And it is also a big thing, but I don't know where it's gonna end up in the studio. I'm probably overusing transitions at this point. Let's just go to the other thing I wanted to show you. This is what we are talking about. It is my resin printer bench, a workbench I built specifically for resin 3D printers. I don't resin print that much. It's taking up a lot of space, and I wanna put my desk here. So I need to move it over here in the main shot of the studio, looking at my normal backdrop. The printers on those shelves behind me, that shelf full of 3D prints, the banner, it's all gonna get replaced by that workbench and then reset up on that workbench. Let's just go ahead and clear that thing off so I can show you the updates that I wanna make to it so it becomes the new backdrop. Before I pile stuff in front of the server rack and enclose it again, I should show you some of the functional 3D prints I've done inside of here. We might as well start off with the ugliest thing. It's this QNAP switch mount that I have in here. It's a 2.5 gig switch. When I ordered it, it was the cheapest 2.5 gig I could get, and it said it was rack mountable, but it wasn't. So I had to make my own rack mount for it, and I just stuck with it rather than returning it and finding one that was actually rack mountable and paying more for it. Then up here in the corner is this PoE injector mount for my Ubiquiti access point that was in my office. So I actually have to take this out of here and put it back in my office. But the most functional thing is probably this rail design that I created down here. If you buy any server rack stuff, you'll find out it's ridiculously overpriced. This shelf up here is like $75, $100 for it. And I wanted something like that to support my smaller NAS case because it's a shallow NAS case. So I couldn't use brackets at the back of it to hold it up. My bigger case for my main NAS I have on these drawer slides here, making it easier to take in and out and service, but they again are not cheap and they're really not the nicest slides either. I really don't want to pay another $60 for slides I didn't particularly like. So what I did here is design up some 3D printable mounts that mount in a 1U space on the rack and allow me to use some 2020 extrusions that I cut to length to act as rails to fully support the server that sits on top of them. Between the prints and the extrusions, I'm significantly cheaper than even the cheapest of shelf brackets I could have gotten on Amazon to produce this shelf setup. First things first, I need to clean off the workbench so I can move it and make the changes to it that I want to make. with that, this thing is cleaned off and ready to start making the modifications that I want to make to it. One of the first ones I want to do is get some paint on this thing. I don't want to have this brown raw wood behind me in the backdrop of the studio, so I got to get some color on this that's going to fit the aesthetic of my space a little bit better. But there's at least one or two modifications I need to make first so that those can then get painted. The first change I want to make is I want to put a leg in the middle of this. I'm not worried about the strength of the bench. You just saw me sitting on it. I had the Elegoo Jupiter on it. That thing is a heavy printer and it was well supported on here. But I want to be able to maybe put some doors on this and have some shelves underneath here for some hidden storage yet. So having that middle will allow me to have some place to hinge off of for doors. That also means I need to set up the miter saw and make some cuts, and I know there's a piece I need for that. So with the miter saw set up here, the problem is dust. You might have noticed I've put down carpet in the studio now. I'm moving my office setup into the studio now. So dust, dirt, and that kind of stuff, as I start to do more workshop projects, is going to become a pretty high concern. This saw has a port on it for dust extraction. I believe it came with an adapter to go to a shop vac. However, I've misplaced it. So I had to jump into Fusion 360, where I designed up this adapter piece and then I threw it to my Voron, where I printed up this part in about an hour. Now it's time for the moment of truth, because I haven't actually tried fitting this on here yet. Nope, too tight. I know what happened there. There's a step on this adapter piece where like the dust bag clips onto, and I used that to actually make a clip-on design for this piece. So it's securely retained on there, and it was just a little too much give for this to slide over it. I might have been better printing this in PETG, which generally has a little more give, and or putting the relief slit that I put on the side of it to go a little higher and let it relieve a little more, or open up the tolerances inside. However, it cracked, but it's still on there, and I had intended to put a zip tie around it anyway, so I think it's still gonna work for what I need. I just might have to revisit this in the future with an updated design for long-term use.
With that out of the way, it's time to cut some wood. With that leg screwed in, there's more I want to do to this thing, but I can get primer on it for now.
Now is definitely a moment where I wish I had somebody to hold the camera for me, because I have to keep stopping and taking gloves off to adjust the camera so I don't get paint on it. This is definitely a factor I'll have to think about moving forward. I just realized that at this moment I'm making a YouTube video about watching paint be applied and dried. So let's move on to insulation. If you're not familiar, this is Rockwool Safe and Sound. It's a mineral wool insulation, so it has an insulating factor, but also a sound absorbing factor to it. A lot of folks use this material to make their own sound panels for studio environments such as mine. I primarily use these moving blankets you'll see all around my studio. They're just there to cut down on reverb, and they're a lot more cost effective than the panels made with this stuff. However, I'm putting this on the backside of the workbench to have a little bit of an insulation factor. As I've noted numerous times, this space is not well insulated, but also to have a bit of a sound absorbing effect. You will be seeing more of that in future studio revamp videos. For now, let's just get this onto the workbench. Traditionally in a house, if I was installing Rockwool, I'd be doing it behind drywall, and it would act as an isolation barrier between rooms. In this situation, I want it to more actively absorb noise, so there needs to be a permeable layer for that noise, vibration, the wavelengths to travel through. Drywall would reflect the sound. I need something that'll allow it to pass through into the Rockwool. There are plenty of materials I could choose from, but I want something fairly neutral, and I recently saw a video by a creator named Michael Alm, who chose to use something that I probably wouldn't have thought of before I'd seen the video when they were making sound panels for their office. Drop cloth for painting. When I picked up the Rockwool at Lowe's, I picked up this as well. I was able to get a gray one. Most of them are kind of the tan canvas, which is not what I want. I don't want that warm color. I'm definitely a cooler colored person, so this is gonna fit pretty well for my application. I started by insulating the top of this thing. I might as well have as much insulation in this area as I can to dampen down the machines that are going to be running on this. I'm looking at you, Bamboo X1. For the back portion of this, I decided to build a mini wall inside of there so it had studs and would fit the batting of the insulation in between there properly.
I'd be lying if I said I left the space at the top and the bottom of this piece on purpose. Measure twice, cut once. Or don't. That said though, I think I could put an LED strip at the bottom of it and light up some glow underneath of it, which will have a nice look to it, so it's not all lost.
With the canvas on the front of it, the wall in place, I came from the backside with the pegboard off and installed the insulation that way, then I could put the pegboard back up. And of course, the finishing touch is the Mandic Relay banner that's gonna go on there for now. This is actually gonna hurt the sound dampening effect because it'll act as a reflection point, but it's what I have for my branding right now.
Sham.
So helpful. By the way, since the start of the video, I have unboxed the Elegoo Neptune 3 Max. I did a live unboxing. Check out the link up here to catch the VOD of that. Review on this one coming as soon as I can get some testing done, which is gonna take a while. Now I need to swap out all the stuff behind me in the backdrop here with the workbench, but I'm not gonna make you sit through all of that. Let's just jump to the finished product. With that, I no longer have a cold block wall behind me. I have a more solid workbench for these printers to live on. I have a better place to display my designs and 3D prints in all of their glory, as well as having a better storage space underneath of the bench. For the moment anyway, it's not all junked up and it has some sense of organization. Personally, there are plenty of things I still want to change and more steps in this project. The storage on the shelves to each side of me absolutely needs to be addressed. Those shelves themselves now look kind of out of place with this center one behind me, but I still like the step forward that my backdrop has now taken. There is one glaring problem though. This empty space over here where that workbench was and where my desk is going to end up, where I'm going to do my design work and edit these videos, where I need to feel inspired, is just an ugly garage door with a couple of moving blankets hanging on it and an empty concrete spot. It simply isn't inspiring to the mind of mad scientist maker such as myself, so I need to address that. But that's for the next studio revamp video. I'm gonna leave you with the two previous episodes in this series so you can check them out for yourself and catch up. Get subscribed so you don't miss the next ones and to ensure your 3D prints don't fail. It's not a guarantee, but it can't hurt. Thanks for coming around, folks. I gotta work on the next project.